Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews. We've got probably the showdown of the century, really. Well, I've tasted both of them, you know. That is the, what would be the original Westy 12, really. It's got, uses the Westy, West Veteran yeast. Originally they was used in, I believe, the West Veteran Ed Brewer and all that, when they started doing these, when they kind of went their own ways. And that's the St. Bernard, St. Bernardus. This one here is the Westy 12. You all know the history. Look the history up. It's interesting, but it's tangled and long and boring. It's not boring. It's boring for me to talk about, if you know what I mean. That is a Westy. That's the one before the bottles were sent out with the chalice and the box and everything. The brick, I think they call it. Anyway. The differences, straight away, that you've got a difference in. I'm using them out of these glasses because I think it's unfair. I've got a St. Bernard glass. I ain't got a chalice, I should say. I haven't got a Westy chalice. Chalice. Now, I can tell the difference straight away. That is St. Bernard. It's a lighter colour. He's murky because he leapt out the glass and all his bits and bobs and everything leapt out of the bottle, I should say, and there's bits and bobs all up into him. And he hasn't held onto his carbonation very well. And this is the Westy 12. Looks beautiful, looks sparkling and lovely. I was able to hold the thingy, the carbonation back. It didn't leap out of the bottle or anything. It done all what was expected. And look at this. I'll shake it a little bit. One minute. Yeah. And up comes a little head and that, a little bit of conditioning and that. And it will die down nicely. That one, it's not gone flat. Don't get me wrong, the St. Bernardus, but it's, you know, this one is now been using it for a while, Westmalle yeast, the West Veteran or Westy 12, and the St. Bernard, or the Bernie, he uses the West Veteran yeast, or strain, that's developed from it. You know, it's like the thing with yeast is it evolves huge, fast, really quick. So you big brewers usually have to keep a frozen version. A frozen version of their yeast at some scientific laboratory or something. And then every now and again they go, we'll get that out again. So let's taste these, tell you what we get as a difference in that. I've already done the reviews, I'm now going to do a comparison. So, into the Bernie. Smell first, shall I? Right, first things first. They're very nice smells. Really lovely, gorgeous, lovely smells. This one smells a bit more kind of doughy, a bit more pizza base, a little bit more bready. There's lots of biscuit, lots of sugar, lots of kind of cracky sort of candy sugar. You know, imagine like, not quite a toffee apple crackiness, but the little cracky things you get over some pastries and biscuits and things like that, when you get that glaze that's like glassy almost. You got that going on with the currants and everything else. So this has got that same glaze, but it's more fruity. It's got a bit more fruit. And it's fruit in a way to balance it more. They definitely are like a Rolls Royce and a kind of... it's like a Rolls Royce how can I put this? Like an Austin Princess or something like that. Now it's a really comfortable car sort of thing, you know, it's nice. Lovely, you know, it's nice if you've ever driven one. The Rolls Royce is different though, it is different. Now, this tastes commercial, but it really tastes absolutely glorious. this tastes like it's lovingly, carefully made. Now, I could be wrong, you know. But don't get me wrong, it's really absolutely glorious beer, and there's not a lot between them. But the conditioning on that doesn't kind of sing favours to me. And I've kept them both exactly the same. Looked after them like they're my little darling children and that, you know. Throwing the kids in the boot and put these on the seats and all that, you know what I mean? But anyway, let's have a taste, shall we? That's so lovely. That's the Burnie. It tastes absolutely glorious. Slight bitter, sort of, just a slight little dry finish on the end. And this has just punched it out of the ring. Absolutely punched it right out of the ring. It's like Mike Tyson just got in with Mr. Muscle or something like that, you know. And he's boom, right, wallop, all out, all done. So, it's a lovely, lovely beer. Don't get me wrong, it's really a lovely, lovely, glorious, lovely beer. But it's like when I did that comparison with Courage Imperial Russian Stout and Harvey's Imperial Russian Stout. It won a competition, and the Courage was lovely, really was lovely, but it was nowhere near as good. Westie 12, really, really good beer. I don't know about the best beer in the world. I wouldn't go that far, but it is an absolute glorious beer, and it's one of the top 10 or top 5 in the world ever. So, absolutely glorious. Westie, wins hands down. See you in the next one. Don't be late, or I'll start without ya. Biddly boo. Cheers. Very quick addendum on the video I've just done with the comparison of the Westie 12 and the St. Bernardus. I poured this in lumps, bumps, cheese, peas and carrots. All the yeast and bits and bobs that was in there. Poured it all in. Had a little drink of that. And do you know what? It's better with the crap in. And it was better than the Westie with the crap in. Glorious. Leave the crap in. Close your eyes. Blindfold yourself. Have a go. See you in the next one. Don't be late. Biddle-boo.